Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff.
He sends this one deep, and they can forget about returning this one.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. He's tackled around the 21-yard line.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. Catches it, and that's all.
I like that they're completing these underneath routes, because pretty soon the defense is going to start to cheat up. That's when the quarterback will have his chance to go over the top for the big play.
Hey, check my 46. Check my 46.
Go. 2, 8.
Motion, motion, motion.
Alert, alert, alert. Catch.
3.
Makes the catch, and he might take it. And he's taken down at about the 35.
That's just a well-executed screen pass. They had the blockers in front, and they got it to him with room to run.
From their own 35-yard line. First down. He steps out at the 39. So they get about 4 yards from play action.
That makes it second and six.
At the 21-yard line. This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage, and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 21. And they make the stop right around the 22-yard line.
Got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
Quick pass, and he tackles him hard at the 22. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
This is the eighth play of this drive. And he's tackled right around the 12-yard line. It's going to be fourth and inches after that long pickup on third down.
Boy, what a throw by the quarterback. Almost equally excellent catch by the receiver, but the defense topped them both by coming up with a stop. You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
Zips it to the back. Brought down at the 15-yard line. They stopped for a 6-yard loss on the play.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
It's second and goal. Ball on the 15-yard line.
Hey, check my 46. Check my 46. Check, check, check.
Nice run there. A halfback option good for 7 yards.
That makes it third and goal.
And this is the 12th play of the drive.
Right left, four down, four down.
Hey, check my 46. Check my 46.
They bring the quarterback down. Fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points.
Nebraska is looking to go up by three. It's up, and it sails through the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Northwestern's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brett, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes, and when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
He makes his way out to about the 35.
That's not everyday speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision.
Makes it out to about the 43.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and 2. 15
to the mic. 15 to the mic. I got 15. Check, check. Check 26. Check 26.
Knocked out of bounds at the 42.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. First down.
The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play.
Hey, Mike, Mike, check, check. Blue 14.
He fights forward to about the 30. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Carries the ball for a nice game.
Good for a game of 6 yards. That'll make it.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Watch 15. Watch 15. Watch 15. Down.
He's scrambling. They'll bring him down around the 15-yard line.
That's a good question. I thought for a while he got his directions messed up.
We've played one. The Cornhuskers lead 3-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2. They push him out at the 10-yard line. So it's fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Northwestern is looking to tie things up. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime.
Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
False start. Offense.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
So the penalty makes it first and 15. Has some daylight. He gets to about the 31-yard line.
Nice play,
it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's taken down around the 34-yard line. So they pick up three on the option keeper.
That'll make it third and one.
Big opening. Tackle made right around the 42-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Laterals back, and he's got space. He makes his way to about the 48. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Now he's scrambling. He's tackled right around the 38-yard line. Complete over the middle.
Pretty nice pickup here. These guys are getting very tight on their timing.
That'll make it second and four.
Second and four. Ball on the 33. Quick throw. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal.
Here's a great example of what this man is capable of. As receivers go, he's as electric as they come.
First and goal from the one, looking to punch this one in. They put everyone up on the line. Touchdown, Cornhuskers.
These blocking backs do a lot of dirty work during the game, so it's good to reward them. Let him barrel it in for a score once in a while.
And he converts the extra point. So that's an 8-play, 79-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. So our score, 10-3. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
He's gobbled up in the backfield.
The defense just met the blockers head-on and drove them back straight into the runner.
From their own 22-yard line, it's second down. And he just gets rid of it. There.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle, and that's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses. I mean, they're playing with a lot of energy, and I think they're doing a nice job up front at the line of scrimmage. And at this point, they're not giving either of these offenses a chance to make a play.
Now, the last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
It's first and 10. Ball in their own 47. Nebraska is up by a touchdown. Quick throw, and he's taken down at the 47.
Any offense is predicated on being able to move efficiently like this.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Tight right. Four down. Hey, check my 46. Check my 46.
Quick strike to the receiver. Tackle right around the 28-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28. Scooped up, and they make the stop at the 18. And they're very lucky to have that ball back.
This receiver needs to put two hands on the ball. He's carrying that thing around like he's trying to give it away.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He's on the run, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out at practice, they told us there are some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against him, maybe get the ball out of the pocket.
Makes a move, and he's in for the touchdown. He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt. He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line. That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 7-8. Throws a strike over the middle. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Cornhuskers lead it by 2 touchdowns.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Chris Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herbstreit's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, we've got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Nebraska is the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Got it, and brought down immediately. He's hit and taken down. Takes the ball inside.
Gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
Tackled after a decent pickup. Pretty good gain on the play by the halfback.
And that shows you why he's such a weapon as a ball carrier. Good gain for the offense.
A gain of a yard on the quarterback keeper.
This guy is very physical, and he does a good job of taking on blockers. I love the toughness here by this quarterback, sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
Brought down at the 28.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. And he's leveled at the 33-yard line.
You know, Brad, I think this is where the game has really changed over the last 5 or 6 years of college football, is the athletic ability and speed now at safety. These guys are covering receivers. They're being asked to be able to be physical and make tackles. But also, now we're starting to see them blitz more and more. And this young man has enough speed to be able to get all the way to the quarterback for a sack.
He's pushed out of bounds around the 28-yard line. And they got him.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Fourth and long here after the sack. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And it's off the upright. No good.
Anybody who tells you that football isn't a game of inches might want to have a talk with this kicker. It doesn't get any closer than that.
So they're just about set to get the game going again. Zips it to the tight end, and down he goes at the 46-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 46-yard line. It to the 34. Woo,
defense, let's go. Let's go.
for a loss.
But the defense here all maintained their assignments and didn't get fooled at all by the option.
From the 37-yard line, second down. Gets out to about the 22-yard line. From the 22-yard line, it's second down. And he hauls that one in. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Second and goal. Ball on the 6-yard line. Got some open field. Touchdown, Nebraska. He splits the uprights with the extra point. An 8-play, 61-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. The score now, 24-3. Nebraska to kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He fights forward to about the 26. That's good for that brings us second and nine. Nice run there.
Good for a gain of 6 yards.
Here we go, here we go.
Watch your
team. Watch your team. Mike your team.
He has some room. Makes it out to about the 49. He gets hit out of bounds around the 41-yard line.
That's a gain of 10. That makes it first and 10.
That's some pretty timid play calling right there. Let's see if they decide to open it up a bit more.
That makes it second and eight.
They'll knock him down for a loss.
I don't think the play developed the way it was supposed to, and the net result is a loss.
They'll line it up again on third down. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Goes down quickly. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
We head to the fourth. Nebraska's got a 3-touchdown advantage. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Mike 15, all right?
Set. 10 blocks.
the 27-yard line. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. Scrambling around. He keeps it and maybe gets 3 yards. He's got it with room to run. Steps out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Fourth down, and it looks like they're going to go for it again. Worked for him last time. Now he tries to buy some time. He breaks it. Tackle made at the 15-yard line. The 7-yard line. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
Watch 15, Mike 15.
Touchdown, Northwestern.
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
He hits the PAT. It was a 14-play, 74-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Tackle at the 46. The Cornhuskers have put up 24 unanswered points. One team can't do anything wrong. The other team can't do anything right. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He's taken down around the 34-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. They'll get him for a loss.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play-action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
Lateral's back. He's at the 20. And they push him out at the 16-yard line. From the 16-yard line, it's first down.
The thing about the option is you're going to have some negative plays, but if you keep running it, it'll create some big play opportunities.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 18-yard line. Just under 3 to go in regulation.
Thank you.
20-yard line.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
2 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
That was sort of a funny-looking play. They needed a lot more yards than they got, and yet they settled for a check down, and nothing was there.
It's up, and the field goal is good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Northwestern's coaches have got to be scratching their heads right now. They know they have to go back to work and go back to work in a hurry.
Well, the coaches are going to want to go back to work, and the players are not going to want to show up in the film room. They're going to be hiding after this performance. This was embarrassing.
And he just gets rid of it. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Once and all, going deep. And they make the stop
right around the 26-yard line.
Just under two to go in the game. He's out of bounds at the 25.
That's a D1 on the play. That brings up second and nine.
Second down and nine to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Throws incomplete.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. 3-yard loss there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Deep pass to the end zone. Just an unbelievable stop where they had to have it on fourth down, and that should be the football game. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
We're set to get restarted as the offense looks to build on the success of their field goal on the last drive. He's to the 40. And he's shoved out of bounds at about the 49. It's first and 10. Ball on the 49. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. And he's tackled at the 49.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Two times.
Go down. Hey, check Mike 46.
Go.
Another run. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
This safety did just a great job of reacting to the run and getting in there to make the tackle.
And that should do it. Our final tally in this one, 27-10, Cornhusker. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.